So, hi everyone, my name is Christian, and I will be talking about an optimal algorithm to solve the combined task allocation and pathfinding problems. So, if we are already talking about hard problems, then it's a good continuation, I guess. So, let's talk a little bit about the motivation. I also think a lot about these industrial type of scenarios. So, picture an industrial production scenario, where on the left side, you basically, the product has to go through a several set of steps in this production process, and basically a robot has to bring the product from one production step to the next. And AGVs are already used in the left part. In the right part, where you are kind of not really sure yet what is going to happen, maybe you want to make your production more robust, it is actually a whole different kind of problem, because you have to dynamically decide where the robot has to go next, when it has to go there. So basically, in the kind of old production scenarios, you will have a fixed schedule, you will have a fixed production layout, and on the right side, you have to be flexible in allocating the robots to these different transportation tasks, and that's basically my main idea. But you could also use the algorithms for other similar problems. I see many people use drones these days, but we are not really sure whether we could use them in production environments yet. So let's just spend 1 minute looking at the literature on this. So if you want to look at multi-agent path planning, which is obviously the session we are in, there's a lot of whole body of research, and also on the multi-agent task allocation, so which agent will take which task. It's very researched very extensively. But if you like want to combine these two problems, as I will do, there is not super much to find. There are, of course, some interesting works that have been done, but I want to extend this. So let's first look at an example. What is the problem we're talking about? So the problem consists of agent positions. These are the blue dots in the graph. So the agents can be just at some points. And then what we think of as tasks are actually transport tasks. Some people, they just have tasks defined as the agent has to visit a position. But in our case, because we want to transport something in the production environment, our tasks are basically pick something up from one position, take it to another position. I have numbered these 1, 2, 3, and these are the purple arrows in the picture. Black is obviously an obstacle. So let's, for example, look at a solution. If we now take this problem, you can see the time is again like the vertical direction. If we look on the right-hand side, we solved basically both sub-problems optimally. So we first solved optimally which robot should take which task, considering the distances of the robots to the tasks and so on, and then we basically just said what is the optimal way to do it, and then later we solved the combined multi-agent path planning problem, also optimally. You will come up with the schedule on the right. You can see that even the total time the agent took is even smaller. But if you look at the left side of the picture, we basically did what I do. We combined these two problems. So we, obviously, the time it takes a robot to reach, for example, the start position of one of these tasks can be influenced by some other robot coming by. But normally we would not do this. So this is what we did on the left side. And we optimized for the total time it took all jobs to complete, again, with the motivation of this industrial scenario. You want, of course, to finish your robots as soon as possible. So basically, you'll see the three numbers in these brackets are basically the three times it took the three jobs that are in this problem to finish. And then we optimize basically for the sum of these times. Again, we can have a look at the solutions they found, basically the allocation solutions they found. With the green arrows, I basically indicate what is the allocation of the agent to a job. And so basically, the only difference between the two solutions is that agents, that jobs 1 and 2 switched from agent 2 and 1, basically, and vice versa. But before we get too carried away, I want to quickly formalize the problem as I understand it. I used a bit of a simplified formulation here, but I think it should be sufficient for the explanations. If you want to have a look at the full formalization, then feel free to look at the paper. So basically, as I said, we have a set of jobs. These jobs are have two sets of coordinates, like start and end position, and we have a set of agents that have their positions as well. We then want to come up with two things. These are the green parts of the inner image. We want to come up with an allocation, what agent takes which job, and we want to come up with a set of paths. Basically, these are, in a way, reducible to each other, so you could read an assignment from a set of paths, and you could also read from an allocation, you could also get an assignment. Also, to stress, on the very right of the slide, you can see I'm actually minimizing the total time of the total waiting time of all of these jobs. Again, this is like comes from this industrial motivation, but you could of course also find other optimization goals for this. So how do we solve this problem? We basically extend the conflict-based search algorithm. I will cover this briefly, and to do this, we build a meta search tree. You can, inside of the nodes of the trees, you have the allocations and also the blocks. The blocks are induced by the conflict-based search. We talk about this later. So if you look at the very first node on the top, the S dot tau is basically the allocation. So we have in this problem two agents and three jobs to allocate. And so basically in the root node, there is no agent has anything to do. And then we start to expand the graph. So we basically look at every possible combination of agents and tasks. So basically the first one is that the first agent takes the first job, the second is third agent takes the second job, and the last one is that the second agent takes the third job, right? And so this is basically, this tree is basically searched by A star, but in every time we extend the tree, we basically calculate the currently required path that the agents would have to take. So for example, in this example, probably the most optimal, based on the heuristic, was the second node. And the second node had agent 0 taking task 1. And so we basically calculated what would it take the agent to go to this task and do it. Then we continued, and basically we have two tasks left, tasks 0 and 2, which are not allocated yet. And then we start to look. Either we want to give the task 2 to the agent 1 as well. And then again, we have to look whether these are feasible. And then the very last node, which obviously was kind of the best bet at this point, based on the heuristic, we find a collision. And this is now basically the thing that we borrowed from CBS. And to solve this collision, we now basically introduce these blocks. I put them into the second variable, this S beta. And so this simply says that the two agents are now colliding at one vertex, which is basically, in this case, in our grid world, it's just 5-3 at time 6, whatever. And then we basically look, either we block the one agent at this point in time, or we block the other agent in this point in time. This is CBS. And then, in this example, it just found an optimal solution by blocking the first agent and then giving the last remaining task to the first agent. We now did some evaluation. I guess you can expect it already. These problems are NP-hard, so it would not be very easy to solve them. But we compared against a TCBS, a nearest neighbor 2. So basically, we just look at all the tasks that are the two closest to each agent, which is just a simple simplification, but it doesn't help a lot, as you will see later. Then we compare it to a greedy approach. Greedy approach just means always the closest agent takes the task. And then we also solve the the navigation problem. The mixed intuition and nonlinear programming approach, this would be basically the optimal separate approach. So with mixed intuition nonlinear programming, we solve the task allocation and then later solve CBS. That's basically what I showed you on the earlier example on the left side. And PPTS is basically a suboptimal algorithm that is actually one of the few that does solve this combined problem, but it solves it with basically passing tokens to agents and then locally optimizing by swapping tasks between agents. So I always compare these solution qualities to the optimal solution that we found. So you can see that the nearest neighbor actually found the optimal solution in all of our cases. Greedy is just a little bit worse, and the separate solution of the problem is basically a lot worse, and FFT to PTS is suboptimal, so it's also quite worse. But if you look at the planning times, it's also not really surprising that our algorithm takes a whole lot of times, and this nearest neighbor search basically takes for four tasks in the problem a little less time. Greed is really fast, and TPTS is almost a constant time required. Considering the time, we will skip the second example, but maybe we will look at it in the questions. So as a summary, our TCBS algorithm solves this combined task allocation and pathfinding problem optimally. Solving the problem is suboptimal. You've seen this in the mixed integer nonlinear programming that I had in the evaluation. This was basically solving both problems in themselves optimally, but we still have a weaker solution quality. And I want to also say our source code is also available, and you can find all of this here. Thank you very much. Here, I would not advise to use it in an actual production environment, to be honest, because it would not scale. But what you have to do here, you would just have to add the job to the list of jobs and then solve the problem again. But one thing that you could do is, it is always easy, or it's a lot simpler to solve like a problem that has like four agents and four jobs. So you could basically select based on some heuristic a number of jobs, as many as you want, but for example, as many as you have agents, and then solve this problem, and then in the next round you just solve the next problem, and so on.
Okay, so let's thank our speaker.